under the stairs in the corner of the basement of the house half a block down the street from Jerry's bait shop. You know the place. Well, anyway, back then life was going swell and everything was just peachy! Except, of course, for the undeniable fact that every single morning, my mother would make me a big old bowl of sauerkraut for breakfast. Instead of my mom, I said, hey, mom, what's up with all the sauerkraut? And my dear sweet mother, she just looked at me like a cow looks at an oncoming train. And she leaned right down next to me, and she said, it's good for you! And then she tied me to the wall and stuck a funnel in my mouth and force-fed me nothing but sauerkraut until I was 26 and a half years old. That's when I swore that someday I would get out of that basement and travel to a magical faraway place where the sun is always shining and the air smells like warm root beer and the towels are oh so fluffy, where the Shriners and the Lepers play their ukuleles all day long and anyone on the street will gladly shave your back for a nickel. Waka waka doo doo, yeah. Well, let me tell you people, it wasn't long at all before my dream came true, because the very next day a local radio station had this contest to see who could correctly guess the number of molecules in Leonard Nimoy's butt. I was off by 3, but I still won the grand prize. That's right, a first-class one-way ticket to Albuquerque. Albuquerque. Oh, yeah. You know, I'd never been on a real airplane before, and I gotta tell you, it was really great. Except that I had to sit between two large Albanian women with excruciatingly severe body odor, and the little kid in back of me kept throwing up the whole time. The flight attendants ran out of Dr. Pepper and salted peanuts. And the in-flight movie was Biodome with Pauly Shore. And oh yeah, 3 of the airplane engines burned out. We went into a tailspin and crashed into a hillside. And the plane exploded in a giant fireball and everybody died. Except for me. You know why? Cause I have my tray table up. And my seat back in the full upright position. Have my tray table up. Back in the full upright position, have my tray table up. And my seat back in the full upright position. So I crawled from the twisted, burning wreckage. I crawled on my hands and knees for 3 full days, dragging along my big leather suitcase and my Garmin bag and my tenor saxophone and my 12-pound bowling ball and my lucky autographed glow-in-the-dark snorkel. But finally I arrived at the world-famous Albuquerque Holiday Inn, where the towels are oh so fluffy, and you can eat your soup right out of the ashtrays if you wanna. It's okay, they're clean. Well, I checked into my room, and I turned down the AC, and I turned on the Spectrovision, and I'm just about to eat that little chocolate mint on my pillow that I love so very, very much, when suddenly there's a knock on the door. Well, now, who could that be? I say, who is it? No answer. Who is it? There's no answer. Who is it? They're not saying anything. So finally I go over and I open the door, and just as I suspected, it's some big fat hermaphrodite with a flock of seagulls haircut and only one nostril. Oh man, I hate it when I'm right. So anyway, he bursts into my room and he grabs my lucky snorkel and I'm like, hey, you can't have that. That snorkel's been just like a snorkel to me. And he's like, tough. And I'm like, give it. And he's like, make me. And I'm like, okay. So I grabbed his leg and he grabbed my esophagus and I bit off his ear and he chewed off my eyebrows and I took out his appendix and he gave me a colonic irrigation. Yes, indeed, you better believe it. And somehow in the middle of it all, the phone got knocked off the hook. And 20 seconds later, I heard a familiar voice. And you know what it said? I'll tell you what it said. It said, if you'd like to make a call, please hang up and try again. If you need help, hang up and then dial your a solemn vow right then and there that I would not rest. I would not sleep for an instant until the one-nostriled man was brought to justice. But first I decided to buy some donuts. So I got in my car and I drove over to the donut shop and I walked on up to the guy behind the counter and he says, yeah, what do you want? I said, you got any glazed donuts? He said, nah, we're out of glazed donuts. I said, well, you got any jelly donuts? He said, no, we're out of jelly donuts. I said, you got any Bavarian cream-filled donuts? He said, no, we're out of Bavarian cream-filled donuts. I said, you got any cinnamon rolls? He said, no, we're out of cinnamon rolls. I said, you got an apple fritters? He said, no, we're out of apple fritters. I said, you got any bear claws? He said, wait a minute, I'll go check. In that case, what do you have? He says, all I got right now is this box of 1 dozen starving, crazed weasels. I said, okay, I'll take that. So he hands me the box, and I open up the lid, and the weasels jump out, and they immediately latch onto my face and start biting me all over. Oh, man, they were just going nuts. They were tearing me apart. You know, I think it was just about that time that a little ditty started going through my head. I believe it went a little something like this. Oh, get him off me! Get him off me! Oh, oh, get him off! Get him off! I ran out into the street with these flesh-eating weasels all over my face, waving my arms all around and just running like a constipated wiener dog. And as luck would have it, that's exactly when I ran into the girl of my dreams. Her name was Zelda. She was a calligraphy enthusiast with a slight overbite and hair the color of strained peaches. I'll never forget the very first thing she said to me. She said, hey, you got weasels on your face. That's when I knew it was true love. We were inseparable after that. Oh, we ate together, we bathed together, we even shared the same piece of mint-flavored dental floss. The world was our burrito. So we got married and we bought us a house and had 2 beautiful children, Nathaniel and Superfly. Oh, we were so very, very, very happy. Oh, yeah. But then one fateful night, Zelda said to me, she said, sweetie pumpkin, do you want to join the Columbia Record Club? I said, whoa! Hold on now, baby! I'm just not ready for that kind of a commitment! So we broke up and I never saw her again, but that's just the way things go! Looking up for me, because about a week later I finally achieved my lifelong dream. That's right, I got me a part-time job at the Sizzler. I even made employee of the month after I put out that grease fire with my face. Oh yeah, everybody was pretty jealous of me after that. I was getting a lot of attitude. Okay, like one time I was out in the parking lot trying to remove my excess earwax with a golf pencil when I see this guy Marty trying to carry a big old sofa up the stairs all by himself. So I say to him, I say, hey, you want me to help you with that? And Marty, he just rolls his eyes and goes, no, I want you to cut off my arms and legs with a chainsaw. So I did. And then he gets all indignant on me. He's like, hey, man, I was just being sarcastic. Well, that's just great. How was I supposed to know that? I'm not a mind reader for crying out loud. Besides, now he's got a really cute nickname, Torso Boy. So what's he complaining about? Say, that reminds me of another amusing anecdote. This guy comes up to me on the street and he tells me he hasn't had a bite in 3 days. Well, I knew what he meant, but just to be funny, I took a big bite out of his jugular vein. And he's yelling and screaming and bleeding all over, and I'm like, hey, come on, don't you get it? But he just keeps rolling around on the sidewalk, bleeding and screaming, ah! 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 And I'm completely missing the irony of the whole situation. Man, some people just can't take a joke, you know? Anyway, where was I? I kind of lost my train of thought. I know it's kind of a roundabout way of saying it, but I guess the whole point I'm trying to make here is I hate sauerkraut! That's all I'm really trying to say. And by the way, if one day you happen to wake up and find yourself in an existential quandary, full of loathing and self-doubt and racked with the pain and isolation of your pitiful, meaningless existence, at least you can take a small bit of comfort in knowing that somewhere out there in this crazy old mixed-up universe of ours, there's still a little place called